was Shauna's biggest struggle, I guess, because she was 0-for-7, I think, from the floor. How do you get her back on track?
Well, I think I don't care how good you are, you're going to have an off night. And she's more than proven over time what kind of player she is. And I think you got to give Baylor a lot of credit. I mean, they're a great team, and they committed defensively to Gardner. They did a great job of it. You know, I think, like I said, if you look at what Sean has done here over her career, I'm not worried about it. Yeah, it's disappointing to have an off night, but everyone has them. That was hers, and I'd be very surprised to come back Saturday with a really good performance.
Is it safe to say Bridget's been the most consistent offensive player the last week or even 2 weeks?
Yeah, I think so. I mean, Bridget's been very aggressive offensively, been more active trying to get to the free throw line, which has been good for her. She's still struggling from the three, hasn't shot the ball probably as well as I think she knows she can. So, but to her credit, she's finding other ways to score. We're trying to post her up a little bit and trying to get her to attack the basket and all those things. But no, I think that, you know, offensively, she's doing the things that we need her to do. And her numbers, I think, will continue to be very good.
K-State starting center is their leading scorer, rebounder, and blocker.
Right.
How do you guys plan to sort of slow her down?
No, it's tough. It seems like every game we run into a good big guy or two, and certainly Brianna Lewis is one of those kids. She's an all-conference player. She's had I think her emergence over time has really kind of transformed their program. You know, I think their program has grown just kind of with her, but she's long, she's skilled, she takes great shots. They do a great job of spreading the court to get her the ball. So I think the big thing is like anytime you play a great player, is you know, limit the touches they get in their comfort zone. Don't give up offensive rebounds. You know, do what you can, and you know, hopefully misses a couple too. But she's a kid that you know, last year we had a really tough time with her here. So you know, I think that she's averaging like 20 points a game over the last few. So really good player, and like I said, they do a lot of good things to get her the ball.
What do you need to do against her zone?
Well, I think the first thing you got to do is make a shot. You know, I think anytime someone zones you, you got to make some shots. But I think, you know, you got to move the ball, and everyone says that, but you got to be smart about it. They do a good job in their zone of extending, jumping in the passing lane. You know, it's kind of an anomaly, really. I mean, they turn you over a lot, and most times when you think about zones, it's not, you don't put those two things together. But and they're going to play every defense there is. I mean, we've practiced 2-3, 3-2. Boxing one, triangle two. I mean, they play it all. I mean, so you got to be very patient, and it always goes back to spacing, ball reversal, and never be surprised when you're open. I mean, sometimes you're going to be open and you didn't realize it because they've reversed the ball, and so shot selection is always important. But you got to make them move. You got to make them react to stuff, and don't be lazy. Don't get caught into it. You can just play catch on the perimeter because they're going to jump a passing lane and make you pay for it.
Do you anticipate, I guess, a different starting lineup for this one?
We're going to make that decision today. We're trying to figure out a couple different things. Obviously, because of their zone, that changes some things. But, you know, what I told the kids after the game the other night is we're just going to continue to keep probing and doing things and try and find a group that fits game to game. And I think that's for us right now, even though it's kind of been that way anyway. I think for the rest of the season, it'll be that even more that way. It's who we're playing. Because, you know, we've been inconsistent in a lot of areas, and we have some kids that can do some things and maybe not do others. So, you know, depending on who we're playing, we'll probably, you know, kind of shift to that kind of lineup. And, you know, it's like if they throw a right-handed pitcher, we'll bat more lefties. And if they throw a left-handed pitcher, we'll bat more righties. So hopefully kind of find a combination game to game.
So there probably won't be one where you say we're going with this one for
No, it won't be. I can promise you that. I we've tried that. We've tried to get into a firm rotation, and here's when it's just not what this team's about. And so we just have to go game to game. Who's playing well? Maybe ride a hot hand once in a while. And, you know, I think that's why you saw Claire play so much in the Baylor game. Her skill set fits what we tried to do in that game, and the next game it might be somebody else. So hopefully it keeps everybody engaged and everyone's going to get a chance, and hopefully we'll find the right combination.
You see Claire getting more minutes then?
Yeah, I hope, you know, I think what she did the other day, again, some of it is who you're playing against. But she went in, she played hard. You know, she's physical around the basket. But like a lot of our kids, you got to make shots. I mean, you can't go for three and miss three layups in any game. So it's a combination of things. But to her credit, she waited her turn. She got in there and competed against as big and strong a team as we're going to play all year. So I think that gives her a chance to come back and get some more minutes. Thank you, everyone.
Thanks, Coach.
Appreciate your time.